بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. أما بعد, indeed all praise belongs to Allah. We praise Allah and we seek His help and we seek Allah's forgiveness. We seek refuge with Allah from the evil within ourselves. And we seek, and from the evil of our actions. Wherever Allah guides, there's none that can misguide the individual. And whoever Allah misguides, there's none that can guide him. I testify that none has the right to be worshipped in truth except Allah alone. Allah has no partners with Him. I testify that Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is Allah's servant and messenger. As for what to proceed, my topic is Ad-Dawabitu Litujannub Al-Fitan, is principles that gonna protect you or keep you away from trials and tribulation. Al-Fitr, jam'u fitna. Fitan, is the plural, and the singular is fitna. Wa huwa ittila'u wa ikhtibar. And fitna is trial and a test. Well, fitan mutanawwi'a, and trials are of different kind. Takunu fitan fi din, and trials could be in one's religion. Takunu fil mal, and it could be in one wealth. Trials could be in one wealth. Watakunu fitan fil awla, and trials could be in one children. Takunu fitan في المقالات ومذائب الاختلاف. And trials could be with in written materials and those methodologies that differs, those incorrect methodologies that differs. Sheikh Saleh Al-Fawzan mentioned in his lecture, Mokif of Muslim in a Fitna, Sheikh Saleh Al-Fawzan mentioned in his lecture, Mokif of Muslim in a Fitna, the stance of the Muslim regarding tribulation. Sheikh mentioned, Sunnatullah subhanahu wa ta'ala fi khalqi an yabtaliyahum. It said that Sheikh Fawzan mentioned trials is the way of Allah in His creation to what? Test the people. وَلَا يَتْرُكُهُمْ بِغَيْرِ إِبْتِلَاءٍ لِأَنَّهُمْ لَوْ تَرَكُوا مِنْ غَيْرِ إِبْتِلَاءٍ لَمْ يَمَيِّزَ الْمُؤْمِنِ مِنَ الْمُنَافِقِ وَلَمْ يُمَيِّزَ الصَّادِقُ مِنَ الْكَاذِبِ ولا حصل الالتباس. And Allah has not left the creation without testing them. And if Allah did not test the creation, Allah test the creation so He could distinguish between the one that is a believer and the one that is a hypocrite. And also Allah could make clear the one that is truthful and the one that is not truthful. And if this did not occur, Allah didn't test the people, there would have been confusion. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala test the individual so He could distinguish between the people. Like the Sheikh said, distinguish between the one that is a believer and the one that is a hypocrite, the one that is truthful and one that is not truthful. كما قال الله سبحانه وتعالى بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ألف لام ميم حسب الناس أن يتركوا أن يقولوا آمنا وهم لا يفتنون لقد فتن الذين من قبلهم يعلمن الله الذين صدقوا ليعلمن يعلمن الكاذبين. Allah mentioned and translated meaning Alif Lam Mim. Do the people think that they'll be left alone and they say we believe without they being tested? Indeed, we have tested those before you so we could make known those who are the ones that are truthful and the ones that are not truthful, that are liars. And Sheikh Fawzan mentioned, he said that الفتن على اختلاف أنواعها وتعددها ترجع على نوعين. النوع الأول فتن الشبهات وتكون في الدين وفي العقيدة. Sheikh Fawzan mentioned trials in its different types and its numerous kind goes back to what? Two matters. The first matters, trials in doubtful matters. And this occurs in the religion and in one creed. Ashubahat. There'd be trials in this matter. And the second, Nu'uthani, Fitna Shahawat, the trials of the desire. وَتَكُونُ فِي سُلُوكِ وَأَخْلَاقِ وَالْمَلَذَّاتِ وَالْمُشْتَهِيَاتِ لِلْبُطُونِ وَفُرُوجِ وَغَيْرِ وغير ذلك من الشهوات. And the trials of the desire is in one's conduct, manners, and those and one's pleasure, and that which and the desire of the stomach and the private part, and other than this, from the fears of what? Desires. So the Sheikh pointed out that trials goes back, although trials is of different types and kind, it goes back to what? To what types? The trial of what? Doubtful matters that comes about. And the trials of what? The desires. Knowing that there will be trials. And we have been informed by the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam that there will be trials and tribulation. And we know that which the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam informed us is nothing but the truth. Because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, whatever he informed us in this inform, it is from Allah. And when you look at the books of ahadith, the books of relating to narrations of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they have chapters that's mentioned ahadith narration pertaining to what? Fitna trials. We find that in Bukhari has a chapter, Kitabul Fitan, the chapter of trials. And Al-Bukhari mentioned the narration pertaining to this matters. And also you find this in other books of ahadith that mention about matters of trials and tribulation. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Badiru bil a'mal fitanan faqat al-layl al-muzlim yusbihu ar-rajul mu'minan wa yumsi kafiran wa yumsi mu'minan wa yusbihu kafiran yubi'u dinahu بعرض من الدنيا أخرجه المسلم من حديث أبي هريرة رضي الله عنهم. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, hasten to do good deeds. Trials will be like the darkness of the night. A night that is completely dark. A man will wake up, will be in the morning a believer, and then by the evening he become a disbeliever. And in the evening he will be, and an individual will be a believer in the evening, and in the morning the individual, will be a believer in the evening, and in the morning he'll be what? A disbeliever. He sell his religion from something of this worldly life. And this is a hadith of Abu Huraira, which is in Muslim. So he shows us, brothers, that trials is something will occur, and that's occurring. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam informed us of this. So I wanted to read something from a Sheikh Abdul Razak Asher Abdul Razak Ibn Abdul Muhsin al-Badr. And this is the title, Ad-Dawabitu Litajannab al-Fitan. Principle that keep us away from trials and tribulations. Because in every matter in this religion, we want to make sure we be upon the path that is correct. And that the path we are upon is correct and is a path that is understanding, that is understood and practiced by the companions. We cannot come about, think about a way or practice a way we don't think is correct, that is not correct. We cannot come with something and say, I'm going to think about something that's going to help me to keep away from trials and tribulation. No, we have to make sure that we go about this in a correct manner. So we don't go to the extreme in these affairs.
An al-Miqdad ibn al-Aswad عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أنه قال إن السعيد من جنب الفتن رواه أبو داود والصحيح الألباني. An authority of Miqdab ibn Aswad, an authority of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, that the Prophet said, indeed the happy one who stay away and distance himself from trials. And this narration is reported by Abu Dawood and is great authentic by Al-Sheikh Al-Bani Rahimahullah. Al-Sheikh Abdul Razak, he mentioned, وَهَا هُنَا يَتَسَاءَلُ كَثِيرٌ مِنَ الْغُرُورِيِّينَ وَالنَّاصِحِينَ مِمَّنْ يُرِيدُونَ لِأَنفُسِهِمُ الْخَيْرِ وَالسَّعَادَةِ وَالسَّعَادَةِ لِأُمَّتِهِمْ وَأُمَّةِ الْإِسْلَامِيَّةِ عَلُوْ وَرِفْعَةِ بِمَا تنا هذه السعادة كيف وكيف يظفر بهذا المقصد الجليل وكيف تتقى الفتن وكيف يجنبها المسلم ويسلم من أوضارها وشرورها وأخطارها. Here, the Sheikh mentioned many of the zealous and those sincere advisors amongst the people, those who want for themselves good and happiness for their nation, and they want greatness and loftiness for the nation of Islam. They ask, how do we attain happiness? How do we attain this great aim? How do we safeguard ourselves from trials? How does a Muslim, how does a Muslim distance himself and stay away from trials? How does the Muslim save himself from the harm of trials, the evil of trials, and its danger? لأن ذلك لأن كل مسلم ناصح غرور لا يريد لنفسه ولا لأمته لما قام في قلبه من النصيحة لنفسه ولعباد الله المؤمنين متمثلا في ذلك قول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم الدين النصيحة قلنا لمن قال لله ولكتابه ولرسوله ولأئمة المسلمين وعامتهم. That is that a Muslim that is a sincere advisor and zealous does not want trials for himself or for his nation. Because that which he has in his heart from, I've given advice to himself and to the believer. And the Muslim acts upon the statement of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, this religion is giving advice. And the companions, they said, to who? And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, to Allah's book, to the Quran, to the messenger, and to the Muslim leader and the general Muslim. والمقتضى النصيحة لنفس ولغير أن يحذر العبد من الفتن ويسعى جاهدا في بعد عنها وتخلص منها وعدم الوقوع فيها وتعوذ بالله من شرها ما ظهر منها وما بطن. And that which is necessitated from advising oneself and advising others is that the servant is aware and is cautious of trials. And the servant strive to distance himself from trials and to free himself from trials and not to fall into what trials. And the individual seek refuge with Allah from the evil of trials, that which apparent from trials and that which is what is hidden from trials. وفي هذه الوقفة أنبئ على نقاط مهمة وأسس عظيمة وضوابط قويمة يكون للمسلم مراعاتها والتزامها أتخلص من الفتن بإذن الله تبارك وتعالى. And the Sheikh said, I want to point to and mention some important points and great fundamentals and sound principle that if a Muslim observe these matters and he adhere to these matters, he will free himself from trials and tribulation by the permission of Allah, the Blessed and Most High. وَهِيَ دَوَابِتُ عَظِيمَةٌ مُسْتَقَاتٌ مِنْ كِتَابِ اللَّهِ الْعَزِيزِ وسنة النبي الكريم. And the Sheikh Abdul Razak, he continues, said that these great principles are taken or extracted from the book of the mighty book of Allah and the Sunnah of the noble Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
وَإِنَّ أَهَمَّ مَا تُتَّقَى بِهِ الْفِتَنُ وَيَتَجَنَّبُهَا بِهِ شَرُّهَا وَدَرُّهَا تَقْوَى اللَّهِ جَلَّ عَلَى وَمَلَازَمَةُ التَّقْوَى فِي السِّرِّ وَالْعَلَنِ وَالْغَيْبِ وَالشَّهَادَةِ. And the Sheikh mentioned that indeed the most important matter that safeguard someone from fitting trials and tribulation, and to keep and distant the person from the evil of trials and its harm, is the fear of Allah. The Shaykh said the most important matters that safeguard a person from trials and distance a person from the evil of trials and its harm, taqwa Allah, the fear of Allah. And that a person always have the fear of Allah in secrecy, openly, alone, and publicly. Person always have the fear of Allah. Wallahu ta'ala yaqul wa man yattaqillaha yaj'al lahu makhraja wa yarzuqhu min haythu la yahtasib. Allah the Most High says, وَمَنْ يَتَّقِ لَا يَجْعَلْ لَهُ مَخْرَجًا. Whoever fears Allah, Allah will make a way out for the individual. وَيَرْزُقُ مِنْ حَيْثُ لَا يَحْتَسِبُ. And Allah will provide for the individual in a way and a manner the individual will not expect it. أي يجعل له مخرجا من كل فتنة وبليئة وشر في الدنيا والآخرة. And the Sheikh Abdul Razak, he said that Allah will make a way out for the injured from every trial, calamity, and evil in this life and in the hereafter. وَيَقُولُ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى. And Allah the Most High says, وَمَنْ يَتَّقِ اللَّهَ يَجْعَلْ لَهُ مِنْ أَمْرِهِ يُسْرًا. And whoever fears Allah, Allah will make the person's affairs easy. وَالْعَاقِبَةُ دَائِمًا لِأَهْلِ التَّقْوَى. And the Sheikh, he said, the end result will always be for the people of taqwa who has the fear of Allah. وَلَمَّا وَقَتِ الْفِتْنَةِ فِي زَمْنِ التَّابِعِينَ أتى نفر من النصحاء إلى طلح ابن حبيب رحمه الله
وقالوا قد وقت الفتنة كيف نتقيها فقال رحمه الله اتقوها بالتقوى. And when the trials came up at the Tabi'un, those who after the companions, or some of those who met the companions, that at their time, because the Tabi'un of different levels. Brother, they have different levels. You got some of them that met a lot of the companions, but these people are after the time of the companions, and most of them met the companions at this time. It's a group of the people that the sincere advisors. They went to Talha ibn Habib and they said to him, indeed the fitna has occurred. How do we safeguard ourselves from the trials? قال رحمه الله and Talha ibn Habib said, safeguard yourself from the trials by having the fear of Allah. قالوا أجملنا التقوى. قال تقوى الله عمل بطاعة الله على نور من الله رجاء رحمة الله وتر معصية الله على نور من الله وخيفة عقاب الله. So they say to Talha ibn Habib, summarize for us at-taqwa. He said the fear of Allah is that you act up and the obedience of Allah with light from Allah, hope in Allah's mercy. And you stay away from the disobeying Allah, from light from Allah, fearing Allah, punishment. وبهذا يعلم أن التقوى ليست كلمة يقولها المرء بلسانه أو دعوة يدعيها. إنما تقوى الله جد واجتهاد ونصح لنفس بطاعة الله وتقرب إليه بما يرضيه. لازم فعل الفرائض وواجبات وبعد عن معاصي ومنكرات. ومن كان هذا شأنه نال بإذن الله العاقبة الحميدة والنهاية الرشيدة. He said, no, Sheikh Abdul Razak, he said, know that taqwa Allah, the fear of Allah, is not a statement a person says with his tongue or something that he claims. Verily, the fear of Allah is hard work and exhorting one effort, advising oneself to obey Allah and to get closer to Allah in that which Allah is pleased with. Especially those obligatory matters and those obligations. And distancing oneself from sins and evil. And whoever fears is like this, by the permission of Allah, this person will have a praiseworthy outcome, a good outcome. And he will have an ending that is guided, that is correct.
نقف عند هذا. So we will stop there inshallah, and we will continue the other principle at another time inshallah, another sitting inshallah, perhaps tomorrow inshallah. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين بارك الله فيكم.